The recent news on 6 June 2019 talk about the government is going to cut the supply of government land sales by 15%. Do you know why the government wants to do so? According to MND, the demand has continued to fall since the introduction of the property cooling measures in July last year. Furthermore, there is a large supply of around 44,000 private housing units in the pipeline. So, what does this mean? They are actually telling you that there are 44,000 of private homes are going to obtain the TOP in coming years. Usually, we have no idea about this figure unless we have a fair comparison with the past history. So, I compare them with the year of 2015 and 2016 because that was the period that has the highest supply in the recent years. From the graph given by URA, there are already more than 50,000 units of 10 TOP in 2015 and 2016. The property market is still able to absorb that, and yet the prices still going upward. Therefore, with the higher population in 2023, do you think the market can absorb the supply which is lower than what we had in 2016? In addition, the news also mentioned there are around 24,000 existing private housing units that remain vacant. So again, what does this mean? Meaning, there are nobody staying in these 24,000 units. However, the vacant units have gradually decreased from the past to 6.3% in the first quarter of 2019. Now with the 93.7% occupancy rate of private housing in Singapore, this is considered as a healthy situation. On the other hand, take a look at the existing and upcoming new launch. With over 90 projects for your choice, I'm sure you will be hesitant which project to choose, right? That's very common, especially if you are first time buying property. Let's take a second look. You will notice that most of the developments are higher end above 2500 PSF. With my rough walk, 20% of them are above 2500 PSF. 12% between 2000 PSF to 2500 PSF, 49% between 1500 PSF and 2000 PSF, and only 19% are below 1500 PSF. All these are measured from the total number of units. Usually, the most affordable one will sell first. So do you think next year, for the supply that below 1500 PSF will be more or less? However, as I mentioned before, there is no one property that fits everyone at all time because the units available and prices are subject to changes. So, you need to understand the right timing and what are the projects to buy for yourself. Now, if you are the first time buying property, you are unsure of which project has the highest potential in the investment point of view, feel free to contact me for a free discussion. I am Steven Chong. Thank you for watching.